My name is Dan Dallmann. People have asked me about the paintings. They're all self-portraits. Every single painting in my section is a self-portrait. A lot of the Italians have asked me why I was so egotistical because I was doing self-portraits all the time. Indeed, they are myself, but they're not really of what I look like, but they're opportunities to explore and to discover the pleasantries of variations within my personality and my expression and my gestures.
I've been a fan of Daniel Dallmann's meticulously realistic paintings for years. He has shown all over the place, top name galleries in New York City as well as Philadelphia. This month he is exhibiting at Philadelphia's Rosenfeld Gallery, and it is a stunning display of the power of direct observation. As you study Dan's paintings, you immediately notice the wide variety of degrees of finish. Some are highly rendered, almost like a Flemish portrait, while others make you think of German expressionism. I wondered how he knows when to stop.
That's actually an interesting question because that's a perennial painting problem. It's a problem of how do you know when a painting is finished? And the fact is, I don't know how to paint very well. Well, I have had one class in painting, so I've never learned how to paint. And somebody asked me one time in a talk, I was giving a talk about my work, and they said, talk to us about your technique. I said, I don't have a technique. I just paint until it looks good. And that is, in fact, true. If in the first 4 hours I have something that looks good to me, and so I feel like I'm satisfied with that, then that's where I stop. The other ones that work longer are simply because they needed more. They were telling me, I want something else. The painting talks to me and says, in so many words or emotions, says something's wrong here. Something has to happen, some other kind of energy, some other kind of space. And my job as an artist is to respond to that message that I receive from the half-finished painting. And if it tells me a good message at 20 minutes into the painting, then I call it done. Although I think I've never done a painting in 20 minutes, but it might be 2 hours. There's a couple of 2 or 3 hour paintings in here. But sometimes they've lasted months before they finally, or I discover how to resolve the thing. Usually that means they get tighter and tighter, but the goal is not to be as tight as I can be. The goal is just to make it satisfying, to make the painting right. If it's right at a halfway point, or if it's right with every little hair in place, then that's where it's right. That's the only thing. That's what painting is about. It's about what the artist prefers, what they like. There isn't any other subject.
One type of painting that Dan has long been associated with is narrative painting. Narrative painting suggests stories and meanings beyond what is possible with simple portraiture. I asked Dan for the lowdown on the two large paintings in this show.
There are two narrative paintings in there, and they both arose from a series I've been doing in the last few years of floating figures. Not necessarily floating, realistically floating, but figures that don't require gravity or a ground plane in order to be in the picture. So there might be a picture of a table that's tipped up this way and a person joining with the table in another direction, from another direction. And that's all that first one, the young man floating over the river. But that was just another one of those. And there was a point where I got to the feet on painting that, doing that painting, And they were so luminous and lovely with the light on them and the skin tones and everything that I simply decided that if it's going to be me, it has to be me as a young person. It can't be me as a 69-year-old man. Nobody's feet look like that at 69 years. So I just revamped the painting through the narrative of imagining it as being me as a young man. Then when I got the next one going, in a similar vein, just the idea of sort of unleashing things from gravity, letting them find a place in the painting that is not necessarily connected to how they would be in reality, but they just belong some other way in the painting. But that one was looking more like me as an age that I am now, so I got the narrative relationship of the artist as an old man, the artist as a young man, and kind of finished both of the paintings off with that idea. Not that it's a diptych, although one could think of it that way, and they look good together. As you see them even in the gallery, you see the one painting and then the other one just to the right is also in the second painting. So you find the one painting exists in both paintings. And so there's a playful kind of studio narrative, and there's also a narrative having to do with, I think ultimately it had to do with love and affection and joy, and hence the titles that refer to that.
I think of Marc Chagall's floating figures about love.
Yeah.
But exactly. Also, you alluded to getting older, and is there anything about the next world implied in these? Or?
No, I never thought of that.
Oh, so.
Absolutely no. No, I am of this world. And in fact, I was late for my own opening today because I'm practicing being late for my funeral. I intend to be.
That's a good way to go out. Thank you very much.
Sure.
One final note. Though Dan only took one painting class and claims to not have a technique, he has managed to fake it well enough that he has kept a job as an art professor at the Tyler School of Art for 42 years. And in fact, he just received the Lindbach Award for Distinguished Teaching, a well-deserved honor for a terrific guy.